Despite frequently traveling near the speed of light, through other dimensions with hyperspace, and near black holes and other supermassive objects, time dilation is not commonly featured or discussed in the Star Wars universe. If it was, Imperial Admiral Dalla would likely not have gotten very much work done at the Maw installation, as the presence of so much gravity within the Maw cluster compared to the rest of the galaxy would have, and I'm putting this extremely simply, slowed time down from the perspective of all those on the station. So, while someone living on Coruscant may have aged 15 years, someone on the Maw installation may have only aged 6, or 1, or maybe even only several weeks, or hours, depending on how the math works out. Are you confused? Well, this isn't meant to be a science lesson, but I'll explain. On a basic level, time dilation refers to the phenomenon where the passage of time is affected and warped by factors like matter and energy, which lead to two people observing the passage of time differently depending on their circumstances. This manifests itself prominently in two forms, gravitational and relative velocity time dilation. Again, on a very, very basic level, gravitational time dilation means that time moves slower as gravity increases. In the real world, the center of the Earth, for example, is actually slightly younger than its crust due to the greater gravity at the planet's core. Relative velocity time dilation, on the other hand, means that time moves slower as you go faster. In the real world, because of the orbital speed of the International Space Station, astronauts on the ISS actually age slower than those on Earth, though the effect is minuscule. However, the effect can be demonstrated through the twin paradox, which is actually extraordinarily relevant to Star Wars. And although it's called a paradox, there's actually no contradiction of logic here. And as we'll see, the main logical inconsistency can be answered through special relativity. So imagine this. If two twins are born on Earth, and one goes on a journey through space, traveling near the speed of light, but eventually returning to Earth, the space-born twin would be younger when they reunited. Mathematically, if the journey was at 80% of the speed of light and 2.4 light years each way, the traveling twin would be 6 years old upon returning, while the other twin on Earth would be 10. You can also say that one would perceive the journey as taking 10 years, while the other 6. And this isn't a contradiction because it's explained by relative velocity time dilation. And this isn't a theory, it's 100% real. But for a fun, sort of realistic take on time dilation, both gravity and velocity based, check out Interstellar. So, with Luke and Leia separated at birth and on different planets, and with Leia traveling throughout the galaxy, the two would be different ages when they met on the Death Star, although perhaps not perceptibly. Though, if time dilation were a thing in the Star Wars universe, it's very possible that if Leia spent a lot of time on a spaceship, by the time of their first meeting, their ages could be significantly different, or if she took up residence near a black hole. But with the frequency of extremely fast travel, the different levels of gravity throughout the universe, and however hyperspace messes with all this, we might expect to see the effects of special relativity and time dilation throughout the entire galaxy. How did the lore treat it? Well, let's start with legends. Hyperspace-capable ships were protected by relativistic shielding, which somehow neutralized the effects of time dilation during jumps. HoloNews, which was an in-universe StarWars.com project, had an article which told the story of Delamede Wozin, who had a faulty relativistic shield. He, and I quote, engaged the jump droid for a trip in out system. It took about 2 hours. When I got out, it was 200 years later. Besides for this one very obscure story, relativistic shielding or time dilation aren't really featured in Star Wars Legends, and there's no explanation that I know of, at least, which explains why relativity not caused by hyperspace isn't a factor. Canon, however, has taken a different approach, rightly, in my opinion. I'll let Pablo Hidalgo explain.
Eduardo Villadao asks, we saw the crew near a black hole, so are we going to see time dilation suffered by them?
You're getting science into our Star Wars, which is always kind of a weird thing. We don't know for sure whether or not the Star Wars galaxy experiences physics or time the same way our galaxy does. In Star Wars, there's like simultaneity, it's called. They have objective time. That is, someone on Tatooine can experience a Tuesday, and someone on Coruscant is experiencing that exact same Tuesday, can pick up the phone and call them. That doesn't happen in our galaxy because of relativity. The rules are different, so who knows what happens when you fly close to a star cluster like that.
So basically, Star Wars now keeps it simple and seems to more or less ignore time dilation, which is honestly pretty common in later sci-fi or sci-fi fantasy. Still, Pablo does include the possibility of weird things happening near black holes. I just doubt that it will be strictly tied to any real-world physics, and I would also be surprised if a strict science version of time dilation ever plays a major role in a Star Wars story. But that's all I have for you guys today. Does that make sense? Do you think Star Wars walks the proper line between science fiction and fantasy? Let me know all of that and more down in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, this has been Eckhart's Ladder. May the Force be with you.